Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again. And hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We meet once again in yet another exclusive, another informative dimension inside the Word of God. And I'm still praying night and day for those that are following the Revelator, those that are sympathizing with the Revelator, those that are partnering with the Revelator, those that are assisting this ministry, those that are following sermons online. May the Lord continue blessing you. Now, I want to enter into a presentation which I have been delaying to usher you into. And this presentation is a message which the Lord has consistently been giving me for quite a while now. And I was banking on the right opportunity and on the right time to present this actual presentation. And today, I want to usher you into a presentation that is titled Relationships. I'm going to be specifying types of relationships. Relationships that you ought to find yourself in. Relationships that I believe they are healthy for you. And relationships that you must never ever find yourself engaging into. And once again, I want to present this presentation hoping that the Holy Spirit, who has always led me, is also going to usher me to present this presentation without me adding any factors of information from my own carnal mind, but through the influence of the Holy Spirit. Now, I want to talk about relationships. There are so many relationships in this world. Relationships that I believe that you and I ought to build. Relationships that I believe that you cannot separate yourself from those relationships. And relationships that come as a result of your experiences and your interference, your affiliations with the outside world. But the first relationship that you must never, ever, ever in your life do away with, a relationship that you ought to preserve, is your relationship with God. Amongst all the relationships that you have in your life, you have one relationship that you must never, ever spoil. A relationship that you ought to always maintain. And for you to maintain that relationship, it's a relationship that you ought to maintain through your life in the Word of God, your life in prayer, your life in your transparency. Also, God needs your transparency, in as much as you have said unto yourself that God knows everything about your life, so there is no need for you to open up to God, or there is no need for you to give God clarity over anything that pertains your life. God wants to relate with you at an even level. God doesn't want to present himself as God in your life. God does not want to practice dictatorship over you. This is why, in as much as God created you, he still gave you a right to choose. He still gave you a right to make decisions, as if he does not have that power to monopolize your own life and determine you to make certain choices. But because he is a just God, but because he is a loving God, he is a God that expects you to be transparent, to be open, to be honest, in everything that you do. And in your honesty, God expects you to be also loving. God expects you to love, not by instruction, but by willingness that comes from your own heart. Now, having realized that you've built a good relationship with the Lord, the matter of relationships continues. Why? Because this one relationship that I've advised you, that it is the umbrella of all relationships, which is your relationship with God. It is the same relationship that will guide you into positive relationships, not relationships that will cause you to end up having suicidal thoughts, not relationships that will end up making you live in bitterness, not relationships that will end up making you live in anger. So many people are living in anger. So many people are living in frustration. Why? Because they've engaged into the wrong relationships. They've joined themselves into relationships that have caused their spiritual life to go down. What it means is that they are actually relationships that you realize that they can actually distance you from God. Why? Because you thought that by being involved in that relationship, you're going to learn certain things that were going to make you get closer to God. If a relationship does not draw you nearer to God, that relationship is bound to distance you from God. And there are certain relationships, like I'm saying, that are bound to make you an enemy of God. Why? Because those relationships, if they are not being led by God, if they are not being influenced by God, so who is driving those relationships? This becomes a question at the end of the day. Who really is driving that relationship? And if it's not God that is driving that relationship, who then is the God who is not the Almighty in heaven, who sits in the highest places, who is behind that relationship? And here I'm talking about relationships of any kind. Relationships come in different diversities. There are relationships in friendships. There are relationships through love relationships. There are relationships through blood relations. All those are relationships that need to be nurtured by the love of God. Relationships that need to be guided by God. Your belief of thinking that you are in full control is the belief that will cause you to end up in the wrong relationships. Why? Because you need God as your compass to know the right people to spend your time with, the right people to shape your life, the right people to advise you. Even in ministry, I've come to a certain point of believing that relationships are very essential. Relationships are like music. Music will guide you to a certain destination. This is why you realize that a certain song that you are going to listen to is going to take you places. It's going to bring certain memories. It's going to determine your behavior. It's going to influence how you talk. It's going to determine the places you visit, the type of people you hang out with. So music is just like relationships. Why? Because relationships are influenced, in as much as music is also influential. So in your relationships, the most important question is to know, who have you chosen to spend your time with? And why have you chosen to spend your time with that particular person? And for what reason? Is that relationship beneficial to your spirit? Is that relationship beneficial to your emotional life? Is that relationship healthy for you? Why? Because there are some relationships, when I look at them, they are not health-wise. They are not advantageous to your spiritual life. They are not advantageous to your emotional and practical life. After having been involved in that relationship, your life is so disturbed. You have lost focus. Why? Because of a relationship that you engaged yourself into. Ever since you started rapping shoulders with that person, you must notice what has changed in your life. What kind of influence has that person brought into your life? And I'm talking about whosoever comes into your life, whoever comes around your life, should be someone that should bring some positive impact. Someone that should be able to leave a mark that makes you a better person. There are some people that have involved themselves in certain relationships that are not profitable. Not profitable at all levels. Not profitable to the extent that they live in bitterness. They live in anger. They live in frustrations, like I said. Every time and every now and again, they've got complaints because of relationships that they allowed to come into their life to minister. Relationships sometimes are like sermons. They're like a gospel that you receive. If that gospel is good enough for you, it's going to make you a better person. How do you still have relationships whereby you are the bootlicker? You have to be the one that is concerned about that relationship. Your relationship is one-sided. It's not even. It's not an even playing ground. It's not an even field. You are the one that has to sacrifice. You are the one that has to suffer. Night and day, you don't sleep. You wake up with a wet pillow because of a relationship. Why? Because that relationship, it needs to be evaluated. When you entered that relationship, what drove you to enter that relationship? Is it God that drove you to enter that relationship? Or you just entered that relationship through peer pressure? The relationship that were pioneered by peer pressures. One got driven into that relationship because of other relationships. You already had bad relationships. And those bad relationships, they are like one April, one bad April amongst the other good Aprils. At the end of the day, all your relationships, they become even as bad as the first relationship was. Why? Because you have not founded the genesis or the foundation of why all your relationships end in tears. It is because you have not allowed our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to be the umbrella, to be the influencer, to be the motivation, to be the determination in each and every relationship that you choose to enter. You have a relationship today where you are the only one that is supposed to text. You are the only one that is supposed to check on someone. You are the only one that is supposed to call that person. If you don't call that person, there is no dialogue, there is no conversation, there is no laughter. You are the one that is releasing all the energy that you have for that relationship to work. And you realize that this relationship is not even. And there are relationships that are like a tug of war, where you are always consistently fighting. And at the same time, you don't want to walk out of that relationship. You want to strive very hard. You want to fight very hard for that relationship. Why are you fighting for relationships that are not working? Why are you sacrificing for relationships that give you nightmares? Why are you stressing yourself because of relationships that are not working? If a relationship is not working, it is worthy to give it a try. It is worthy to give it time. But there comes a time when you have to walk away. There are people that I have told personally is the revelator to walk out of certain relationships if they are not working. Of course, you wouldn't advise someone to quickly walk out of a relationship Why? Because some people have invested their time in certain relationships. They have invested certain secrets. They have invested even knowledge. A lot of things are shared in a relationship. Some have invested even material things in the relationships that they have. So I understand how difficult it is for one to just walk away from that relationship. But sometimes there comes a time when you have to walk away from a certain relationship. In as much as you invested a lot in that relationship, but you need to walk away and create a new path. You need to walk away and start a new journey. Why? Because there are certain things that might never happen in your life. There are certain things that you might never achieve as long as you are in that relationship. So you need to reach a certain point in life where you are prepared to walk away. You need to reach a certain point in life where you are prepared to start a new journey. You need to reach a certain point of time where you forget about your past relationships. Some of you, you have walked away from certain negative relationships. You have managed to move on, but you haven't moved on. Why? Because your past relationships, they keep growing like shrubs. They keep growing like trees that you have to uproot and cut off. They keep on growing like branches, and you are the stem, and you are being suffocated by those relationships that you can no longer do away with. Why? Because in as much as they are not good for you, you continue accommodating those relationships. And my question is, why are you suppressing yourself instead of just doing away with them? So the gospel is not just about doing away with the relationships. If a relationship is good, you need to keep it. There are some people that haven't realized that they are in good relationships. They will only know once those people that they are involved with, those people that they are affiliated with, those people that they are related with are gone. And you start realizing the importance of another person when that person is already gone. There comes a time in life when you have to open your spiritual eyes and notice the good that is in someone else. How much someone else has sacrificed for you. And if you can't realize how other people have sacrificed for you, you'll never realize the good relationships that you have. Sometimes you need to also reach a certain degree in life of accepting that you are the definition of any good relationship that you can ever have. I've seen people that walk out of good relationships, and they blame the people that were doing good for them, and they never realize how much good those people were to them. And they only realize once they have walked out of those relationships, or walking from one relationship to the other, and you never accept that you are wrong. You also need to reach a point in life where you accept that for a relationship to become a relationship, you have a part to play. You have a part of positivity. You have a part of working for that relationship, investing into that relationship with the love that is required for that relationship to last. Don't always be nagging in a relationship. Don't always be the one that is complaining in a relationship. Before you complain, you need to ask yourself, what have you invested? What is your input in that relationship? As I've said earlier, you need Jesus Christ in this relationship. You need Jesus to be your mentor, to be your advisor in each and every relationship that you are affiliated in. Might it be a business relationship? Might it be a love relationship? Might it be a social relationship? Might it be a relationship between you and your mentor? You need Jesus to help you out. You need Jesus to guide you. You need Jesus to mentor you. You need Jesus to be your comforter all the way until the end, in the name of Jesus.